So, I have a confession to make. For my classroom, I always wanted a hairless guinea pig. They sell them at some pet stores, but they can be really hard to find. And while I doubt they'd do so well in the wild, their genetics are fascinating. And so are guinea pigs. We spend quite some time on LOL cats, but we'd spend even more time if someone would make a funny guinea pig site. Most guinea pigs have hair. This is because of their DNA. DNA makes up genes, and the guinea pigs received genes from both their mother and their father. An allele is a form of a gene, and often represented by a letter. In this case, we'll use the letter H for hair. A hairless guinea pig has two recessive alleles for the trait of having or not having hair. A recessive allele is usually represented by a lowercase letter, or allele. By recessive, it means that the allele will not usually show up. The only way it will show up is if there is no dominant allele present. A dominant allele is represented by a capital letter, and it's an allele that will show up. Think of it as dominating. So a hairless guinea pig does not have a dominant allele for hair, and that's why the recessive trait, not having hair, shows up. A hairless guinea pig's genotype, that's the genetic makeup of an organism, can be represented as a lowercase little h, little h. A guinea pig that does have hair can be represented as a big H, or a big H, little h. See, it only takes one dominant allele, a capital H, for a trait to show up. That dominating allele means that the recessive allele is hidden. Now, we're not quite done with the vocab here. A genotype of big H, or little h, is considered homozygous. The root in this word means same, and they are the same case. Big H, those are both capital letters, and little h, those are both lowercase letters. So big H is called homozygous dominant because of the capitals, and little h is homozygous recessive because of the lowercase. A genotype of big H, little h is considered heterozygous. The root in this word means different because their letters are different cases. One is a capital and one is a lowercase. If I were to show you a guinea pig with hair, would you know its genotype? Well, you would know it's not little h, because if it was little h, then it would be hairless. But remember, a guinea pig with hair, it could be big H, or big H, little h. We don't really know. I mean, we could do a test cross to eventually determine this, but you can't tell just by looking at the guinea pig. Now, if we had a hairless guinea pig, we do know for sure that it's little h, because if it did have a capital letter, even one, that dominating allele would take over and it would have hair. So let's try a monohybrid cross. The root mono means one because it focuses on one trait, in this case, hair. And that means a Punnett square would need to be created like this with four squares. In our cross, we are going to cross two heterozygous guinea pigs. So let's look at this in steps. Step one, first, figure out the genotypes of the parents. Heterozygous means big H, little h. Step two, place one parent along the top of the Punnett square, outside of the boxes like this, and place the other parent along the left side of the square, outside of the boxes like this. Step three, cross them. For formatting purposes, we always put the capital letter first. The results that you get in the squares would be the offspring, the babies. Now, if I were to ask you the genotypes of the babies, you could list them out. One, big H, two, big H, little h, and one, little h. I could even turn that into a genotype ratio of one homozygous dominant to two heterozygous to one homozygous recessive, or a percentage. 25% are homozygous dominant, 50% are heterozygous, and 25% are homozygous recessive. Well, what if I asked about the phenotypes? What does that mean? I like to think that pheno sounds like physical. So the phenotype would be the physical traits of that organism. And in this example, it's whether they have hair or not. Now remember, any babies that have a capital H have a dominating allele, and they will have hair. So the babies that are big H, or big H, little H, they have hair. So three of them here, the one big H baby and the two big H, little H babies, they all have hair. The homozygous recessive baby, which was little H, that baby has no dominant allele present. So this little guy would be hairless. So you could say the phenotype ratio is three have hair to one that's hairless. Or a phenotype percentage could be 75% hair, 25% hairless. One thing to emphasize about Punnett squares is that they are predictions. These are probabilities. This means it's not necessarily exactly what you're going to get. For example, it's a probability that a child has a 50-50 chance of being born a boy or a girl. But we all know families that only have children that are girls, or families that only have children that are boys. Probabilities are predictions. Another reason to love biology, it's exciting. Well, that's it for the Amoeba Sisters, and we remind you to stay curious.